let's talk a little bit about Generation X. The generation so terrifying they couldn't even give it a fucking name. So Gen Xers were raised in a very interesting period of time. They were raised by baby boomers, so they knew a very older and maybe kind of feral way to exist and live their life. But then they were also old enough, so when the internet and a lot of new technology started coming out, they also knew a lot more. So they had this kind of ability to cherry pick the best traits of baby boomers and millennials, which makes them some of the most dangerous fucking people in the world. Most of the Gen Xers I knew either went to the military, went to rehab, or went to jail. That means the ones that are left are fucking survivors. So for as many changes in music and style and culture that you think you've been through, in the last 50 years, they've been through the most. Also, mental illness wasn't trendy back then. So any kind of mental illness that they had, they usually didn't get any treatment for it. So they had to learn how to cope with it themselves. Medications weren't as delicate or as effective back then. And that leaves you with some very fucking interesting people. Get yourself a Gen X friend, but they'll probably just tell you to fuck off.
If you press that button, you will receive $1 million, but someone that you don't know will die. If I press it more than once, do I get more money? Well, yes, but then more people.
You're all wrong. The earth isn't flat or round. It's fucked.
Joe, me gotta go, me oh my oh. Me gotta go, pull the P-Row down the bayou. My Yvonne, the sweetest one, me oh my oh. Son of a gun, we'll have big fun on the bayou.
Hey, somebody just slid into my DM and said I remind them of KFC. I said, of course I do. I got breasts, legs, and thighs, and their finger looking good. Boop!
New trend. Film looking down at your camera, then move it up to automatically look more attractive.
We.
I call the police. They're gonna be here in 10 minutes.
Okay. Then that leave me 9 to beat the hell out of you.
You think? I know Taekwondo.
And I know whoop your ass.
I got a new life. You would hardly recognize me. I'm so glad.
Hey, somebody just slid into my DM and said I remind them of KFC. I said, of course I do. I got breasts, legs, and thighs, and their finger looking good. Boop.
You don't have to like me. But I wish you would, because I'm a delight, and I host really great tea parties, and I make cookies, and I will love you.
I don't really give a fuck. I really don't give a fuck.
If you can sing the chorus to this song, I want to be your best friend.
Hey, pretty lady, won't you give me a sign? I'd give anything to make my own mind. I'll be your friend and be at your beck and call.
I've told you a million times not to talk to me when I'm doing my lashes.
Name something you might hurt yourself riding on.
Oh, God. You know what I'm thinking?
Shut your mouth, baby, stand and deliver. Holy hells, will they make me a sinner like a river?
Hello? I'm awake today. I'm not happy about it. And it's gonna be everybody's problem.
If you are not a fat girl, big woman, keep it moving, keep scrolling, okay? It doesn't pertain to you. We are doing Put a finger down, fat girl edition. Put a finger down if someone has ever told you that your face is beautiful, but just your face. Put a finger down if someone has ever told you, you would look so pretty if you lost weight. Put a finger down if you've experienced chub rub. Put a finger down if you've ever made a profile picture of just your face. Put a finger down if you've ever been on Tinder, got all the hot dudes until they saw your bod. Put a finger down if you sweat literally everywhere. Put a finger down if it's a legit struggle to shave, you know. Put a finger down if you eat like a normal person, you just have shit genes. Put a finger down if you tried every diet known to man. Put a finger down if clothes shopping is literal hell.
All I want is a tall bearded man that will take me out to eat, grab my thighs in the car, and slap my butt when I get out. Is that too much to ask?
Thank you for calling. How can I help you?
Hi, my best friend and I were hoping to stay with y'all for a couple of days, so I thought I'd call ahead, see if you had any deals or discounts. You know, like buy one, get one free, buy one, get one half off. Oh, we were also hoping to get rooms next to each other, but on the same floor is fine, but if that's still not available, no worries at all.
Ma'am, this is a mental hospital.
Oh yeah, I know.
Oh, just double checking. Yes, we do have deals for that.
Awesome.